Hey, Master Gardeners. It's National Invasive Species Awareness Week, and so I thought I'd divert from just doing plant invasive species to do an insect invasive. I'm not an entomologist, but I'm a lover of trees, and there's a tree here that is particularly beautiful. It's the hemlock. And I've hiked up here into Gunpowder Falls State Park along the Gunpowder River near the Pretty Boy Dam area, and on the tips of an MDA worker, Chelsea, thankfully, told me where there would be some hemlock woolly adelgid found on the hemlocks. Sure enough, I hiked out here and I found them, and I want to show them to you so that you know what this insect is. This insect was brought into the United States in 1924 accidentally, and at that point it was mostly detected around the 1950s, where it started to spread up to Georgia, down through Maine. And now there's all kinds of federal and state funding that goes forth fighting to save hemlock trees, because the hemlock woolly adelgid insect actually can kill a hemlock in 4 to 10 years. And so why is everybody concerned about these hemlocks? They provide incredible ecosystem services. If you know anything about hemlocks, they have a real dense canopy. And when they're located along the stream areas, they actually provide shade to the water, which allows the soil water temperature to stay lower. And therefore, it helps the trout population and the fishermen. So that's one big tip for them. Plus, this dense canopy is excellent cover for animals. As I hiked around the hillside here trying to find some specimens to show to you, I saw numerous deer beds in the snow, because it's wonderful habitat for the deer to lay under when the snow's occurring. It's shelter for salamanders, and all kinds of migrating birds can sit in them all the time during storms and night protection. Plus, they've done research. If you want to go to the federal website and look that up, they found 800 different insects that live in this little habitat underneath of the shade-loving hemlocks. And that's one thing that's unique. They not only are found on the shady sides of the hill, but they're adaptable to be in different areas. They tolerate very shallow soils, so it's kind of a unique habitat where they can be found. And that fast dryness they can adapt to. So they actually stabilize soil and prevent sediment from becoming a pollutant in our waters. So those are lots of benefits to our environment, and that's why there's so much money being spent. And then there's also an economic impact. In the recreation areas like Swallow Falls, maybe you've been there, New Germany, it's a cornerstone species, because in those high recreation areas, it's just beautiful. If you haven't been there, go take a look at how lovely they are. And if there was a loss of all the hemlocks, that would devastate the income in those areas. Plus, in the rural communities, there's a lot of people that look for morels, ginseng, and gold seal, and those are different plants that enjoy this shady, moist habitat provided by hemlocks. So come on, let's take a look so you know what this hemlock woolly adelgid looks like. It is actually a true bug. Well, here's the hemlock. This is the guy I found him on right there. That's the hemlock tree. I found him over here on this shady side and located right next to this adorable little stream. So let's zoom in so you can learn what this little insect is. So an adelgid is a type of aphid, and they suck on the leaves. So this is a hemlock, Suga canadensis. And see those little white things all along in there? Those are actually the hemlock woolly adelgids. They say they look like cotton swabs, so I stuck some cotton swab there. 1/4 the size of a cotton swab. Now, during the summer months, this insect is less active, so you don't find that woolly white portion as much. Now, when you look at that woolly, let me try to hold it still. You're not looking at the insect itself. That's like a woolly protective coating that it makes on itself. Instead, the insect is too small to see. It's kind of not visible to your naked eye. But there it is. Hemlocks are easy to identify because they kind of appear to be two ranked. They have little petioles on each one of their needles. So that's a pretty cool aspect about hemlocks. So this little woolly adelgid is sucking the juice out of the foliage. And what effect does that have? It actually causes the branches. The needles get a gray in color, which I couldn't find to show you on any of these. But it'll actually suck so much juice out of the needles that you'll actually have stem dieback, which is what's occurring on some of those branches out there. We see actual foliage loss, and eventually it sucks so much juice out in the 5 to 10 years that whammo, you've lost your species. Here's another big one over in this area. Usually the damage occurs in the spring months. This is a habitat, there's some poplars in here. but it's a really steep hillside. Here's another beautiful one up there. There's another big hemlock up the hill there. So they're less visible in midsummer, but very active in the spring months. So what can we do about these guys? There's different controls. They're releasing predatory insects to try to consume them, but we're not having a lot of success. They're actually collecting some different types of insects in the western part of the United States and releasing them, but not having super big success with that method. So the Maryland Department of Agriculture is actually in the high visibility areas. They're actually doing treatments on them where they're protecting their bark and around their root systems and things. And then you at home, you can apply products that will deter them. If you had a hemlock at home, you could attempt the treatments of an oil, which is a dormant spray, but do your homework, look it up at the Home and Garden Information Center. But another cool fact that I just read, Stanton Gill had it in his IPM net, that they're doing breeding. You can go over to the National Arboretum's the one doing the breeding, but there's research being done through the National Arboretum, and they're trying to breed resistant varieties of hemlocks. And they're trying to cross Tsuga chinensis with Tsuga canadensis. And we have another one, a Tsuga caroliniana. So we have a Carolina species. But the hemlock wooly adelgid is attacking all of these different hemlocks. And so we need to just be aware that our tax dollars are really going for a valuable saving of our hemlock trees. So there's your invasive species for this week, hemlock wooly adelgid.